Alone and together, these women in the West Bank are banging their pots and pans in protest against domestic violence. The UN says cases of domestic abuse during the global pandemic have increased by 20%. So now women all over the world have taken matters into their own hands to help other women in their neighbourhoods. During the West Bank's 8-week lockdown, people stood on their balconies in a neighbourhood to let vulnerable women know that their homes were open to them. Rabab, who's a woman's counsellor, has been using Instagram and WhatsApp to reach out to vulnerable women who may be trapped with their abusers.
So وصلتني رسالة من مرأة اللي بتستقبل رسائل الصوتية بشكل يومي فهيك رجعت لي وكتبت لي رباب هل أنه زوج بيضل يحكي كلمات بذيئة لزوجته هذا عنف؟ هل أنه هو بسخر مني ومن طبخاتي ومن ترتيبي للبيت هل هذا عنف؟ بعيشوا تحت الإهانة والظلم والعدوان وما بعرفوا شو لازم يعملوا فمرات كثير أي رسالة صغيرة ممكن تعملهن تغيير بحياتهن.
More than 4,000 kilometres away in India, women have also set up a local phone line to take calls from isolated women. The provinces that make up the area have some of the highest numbers of domestic violence in India. By taking dozens of calls a day, organising food deliveries, Kavitha can check in regularly with these women so they aren't trapped alone. It's impossible to socially distance in built-up poorer communities. Brazil has one of the highest rates of domestic violence. Government figures suggest that every 2 minutes, an act of violence against women is committed in the population of over 200 million people. In Mare slum, one of the largest in Rio, people can live with more than 10 people in one house, sometimes with their abusers. Eliana is a community leader in Mare. She's employed women who may be in abusive homes to cook for the homeless during the pandemic. During the one-month lockdown in Houston, Texas, a group of students used social media and dressed in denim so women could approach them if they needed help.
For a lot of people, staying at home could lead to potentially worse health outcomes and very dangerous situations.
Ashri and other volunteers delivered food to dozens of vulnerable women who had been in touch. Insider messages telling them where they can get help if they need it. Although many global lockdowns are easing, the World Health Organization says countries must be on alert for a second wave of COVID-19 infections. Coronavirus has shown us the importance of local community. And for these women, the strength that comes from looking after each other.